Black Lightning episode 8, man. It starts off with Jefferson Pierce and Anessa training. Because as you know, Anessa and Jefferson Pierce, they found out that they're both superheroes. So they're training. Jefferson Pierce doesn't want his daughter out there dying or anything. Because remember, the mother told Jefferson Pierce, hey, she gonna get out there anyway. As best as she's best prepared. So they're training. And, you know, they training in the little, you know, the little lair or the hideout. And he's telling her to, you know, anticipate things before they happen. We move on. That story advances. Man, we find out that the white guy, he still has some type of connection to the bad guys that we don't know about, man. But we find that out. We find out the climax of that later, man. Also, Lala's back, as we found out on the episode before. Lala is back, and he's just weird, man. Some of his the cats he used to be over, they're in the they're in Tobias's club. And this was a Tobias-free episode, by the way, but they're in Tobias's club and they're dancing and everything. I mean, they're rapping. And, you know, Lala comes out of nowhere and they're like, whoa, you know, we didn't expect you to be here. You know, we didn't know. We thought you were in jail. We thought you were dead. And he's just sitting there just, you know, those guys are just like, you know, what do we do here? You know, they're rapping and the song was actually kind of good. And Lala's like, all right, keep rapping. I like that song. Then they move on. And then later on, Lala and... man, what's the girl that he killed? The girl that he killed, the woman that he killed who had the daughter who died by the 300 or by the 100, I'm sorry. The Chief Keith group, 300 or whatever. Anyway, Lala is riding in the car with those two guys that were rapping, right? And he's the only one that could see the mother of the daughter who died. So he's back there having a conversation with her, and she's all like, you should kill both of them. And he's like, I don't want to kill them. They drive. You know, I might like them. I don't know if I'm going to kill them. And the guys are sitting in the front seat like, man, what is going on here? They already scared. They already don't know what to expect because they didn't expect him to be alive. But now they hear him having this conversation by himself, or what they perceive to be by himself. And, you know, eventually they're like, man, are you okay? And he's like, yeah, man, I'm good. But we find out that Lala is conflicted because he doesn't know what's going on. He didn't even know he died, man. But back to Anessa and Jefferson Pierce. So they're in the woods, man. They're trying to find out. Basically what they're trying to do is Black Lightning is wanted now. They show clips in the morning. I mean, when the show first came on, they show clips of different people just kind of, you know, Black Lightning beating up on young black boys. Now he's beating up on women. What's next, kids? So he's wanted. So he's trying to clear his name. So he's not going out as Black Lightning. And what I thought was super dope about this episode is Black Lightning, or Jefferson Pierce, had on a sweatshirt. It was pretty much a Black Panther sweatshirt. And I'm not talking about Black Panther, the Marvel, of course. You know, the Marvel superhero, because, of course, you know, you can't do Marvel in DC. But the real-life Black Panther party sweatshirt. But, you know, they're in the woods and everything. And they're trying to find clues. And while Anessa and Jefferson Pierce are in the woods, you know, some guy comes out. One of these crooked policemen come out, and Jefferson Pierce is like, man, let me go sneak up on him and see what's happening. And as soon as, and he tells Anessa, stay here, don't you do nothing. So he's sneaking up. And Anessa, remember when the episode first came on, Jefferson Pierce was telling Anessa, you have to anticipate stuff. So Jefferson Pierce is up there, and as soon as the guy picks up the gun explodes, but Anessa runs out in enough time to save Jefferson Pierce. You know, and while she's coming, you can see him saying, I told you to stay, you're behind, I'm over there. But then, after the fact, after everything blows up, and Anessa and Jefferson Pierce are still alive, he's all happy. He goes home, he's telling his wife, he's all extra. Man, she saved me, blah, 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 woo, 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 woo. Now, before we go on from there, Jefferson Pierce's wife and the white guy who be mentoring him, they had like this exchange, man, that was more revealing as to why the white guy is just so, what's the word? I don't want to say awkward, but suspicious right now. We find out, well, we don't find out exactly what's happening when the white guy is talking to Jefferson Pierce's wife, but we find out why, you could tell we're about to get an answer why he's so suspicious. So, Jefferson Pierce, so pretty much the white guy's like, look, you know, Mrs. Pierce, I got to have this conversation with Jefferson. So pretty much, let's go back. Jefferson Pierce and his wife, you know, he's all excited. Yeah, she saved me, she saved me. And Jefferson Pierce's wife just has this, like, this look like, man, look, you need to go talk to the white guy because, you know, he needs to explain things to you. So Jefferson Pierce goes to the white guy. I think his name is like Gabby or something. I keep calling him the white guy. But he goes to the white guy, and the white guy is like, look, man, I was here on this mission 30 years ago. Before I met you or whatever, I came here because I was with this group, and pretty much what I got from what he was saying, the group was kind of trying to like inject people in urban neighborhoods with this serum to kind of subdue them. That's what I think, but it ended up turning them into metahumans. And when the white guy found out that they were doing it to children, he was like, oh, nah. So he went and leaked the information to Jefferson Pierce's dad. And then that's when the people, the bad guys, found Jefferson Pierce's dad and they killed him. So now everything's making sense. And the white guy felt guilty, so he had to take in Jefferson Pierce because he felt like he had his dad killed. So now things are making sense, because for weeks we were confused, man. And Jefferson Pierce, of course, he's upset because he's pretty much like, you're the one who had my father dead and you turned me into this. And the guy's like, no, I had nothing to do with the experiment. And I didn't know that your father was going to die, man. I felt bad. Like, I had to leak the information. So Jefferson Pierce is like, hey, man, stay away from me. Okay? So that's pretty much how the episode ends. But also in this episode, we find out that his youngest daughter, which we, you know, if you keep up with comic books and you read up on this stuff, you know, she's discovering that she has power. Jennifer, during school, her friend, Jennifer's friend, climbed up on this ladder to put her, they were hanging like class president, you know, vote for me type pictures. And she climbed up on this high thing. I'm looking like, man, that thing high. Why she climb? And Jennifer was like, hey, come on, man. Come on, baby. You got to come down. This is too high. So the girl got up there and she kind of slipped. And Jennifer had her phone in her hand and she got like nervous and she like, no. And her eyes turned into like, you know, they turned fire red and she burned her phone and dropped it. And man, you could just tell it was like, okay. First, Anessa gets her power. We're already training Anessa to fight alongside Jefferson Pierce. Now Jennifer's getting her power, man. And the episode goes off, and we see that next week, it looks like they're already having that conversation. Jennifer and her dad are going to have that conversation. Because at the end of this show also, Jennifer went to Anessa like, look, man, this happened to me. While at school, I burnt my phone with my hand. And, you know, Anessa was like, you know, Anessa ain't say nothing. She's like, okay, you're a superhero too, man. We just family full of superheroes, man. But next week, I think next week's episode is going to be good, man. This was a recap of Black Lightning, episode 8, man. I'm Bread Tuck Rob, Bread Tuck Gang forever. Y'all mucho take it easy.